Business aims and activities. Private sector aims. The aim of a business in the private sector is to survive by making a profit. This may be a sole trader working alone, like a news agent, or thousands of shareholders in a large public limited company. Businesses gain a larger market share, a percentage of overall sales in an industry, by increasing the sales of their products against competitors. This may involve reducing prices. To win the loyalty of customers and encourage repeat sales, customers returning to buy the product from the same business, businesses need to be reliable and provide a quality service to their customers. Private sector activities. The activities of industry can be divided into stages: primary, secondary, and tertiary production. These stages form the chain of production and provide consumers with the finished goods. Primary production. This involves acquiring raw materials. For example, metals and coal have to be mined, oil drilled from the ground, rubber tapped from trees, foodstuffs farmed, and fish trawled. This is sometimes known as extractive production. Secondary production is the manufacturing and assembly process. This involves converting raw materials into components, e.g. making plastics from oil, and assembling the product, e.g. building houses, bridges, and roads. Tertiary production. This refers to the commercial services that support the production and distribution process, e.g. insurance, transport, advertising, warehousing, and retail, teaching and healthcare. Limited companies. All limited companies are incorporated firm with separate legal existence, which means they can sue or own assets in their own right. Their owners are not personally liable for the firm's debts. Their losses are limited to the amount they invested in the business, limited liability. The ownership of a limited company is divided up into equal parts called shares. Whoever owns one or more of these is called a shareholder. A public limited company, PLC, can sell its shares on the stock market, while a private limited company, LTD, cannot. Unlike a sole trader or a partnership, the owners of a limited company are not involved in the running of the business, unless they have been elected to the board of directors. Public and private limited companies in general, both types of company, must audit an independent check, know the accounts of the company, their accounts, and have them available for inspection. There are, however, exceptions to this rule for smaller private limited companies. Both types of company must indicate their status in their name, usually by using the abbreviation PLC or LTD. This lets traders know that their liability is limited and that debts cannot be recovered from the personal funds of the company shareholders. Private limited companies' advantages. Disadvantages. Easy and inexpensive to set up. Lack of capital due to no share issue. Ownership and control are closely connected, e.g. board of directors are usually the main shareholders. No benefit from economies of scale, e.g. bulk buying, cheaper borrowing. Small and less bureaucratic than PLCs, e.g. decisions can be taken more quickly. Public limited companies. Advantages. Disadvantages. Raise large amount of capital from share issue. Become too large, resulting in poor labor relations. Benefit from economies of scale, e.g. bulk buying, cheaper borrowing. Conflict of interest between shareholders and the board of directors. Produce goods at lower unit cost. Possibility of takeover or merger, because shares can be bought by anyone. Sole traders. A sole trader describes any business that is owned and controlled by one person, although they may employ workers, e.g. a newsagent's shop. Individuals who provide a specialist service like hairdressers, plumbers, or photographers are also sole traders. Sole traders do not have a separate legal existence from their owner. As a result, the owners are personally liable for the firm's debts, and may have to pay them out of their own pocket. This is called unlimited liability. Advantages 1. The firms are usually small and easy to set up. 2. Generally, only a small amount of capital needs to be invested, which reduces the initial startup cost. 3. The wage bill will usually be low, because there are few or no employees. 4. It is easier to keep overall control, because the owner has a hands-on approach to running the business and can make decisions without consulting anyone else. Disadvantages 1. The sole trader has no one to share the responsibility of running the business with. A good hairdresser, for example, may not be very good at handling the accounts. 2. Sole traders often work long hours and find it difficult to take holidays or time off if they are ill. 3. Developing the business is also limited by the amount of capital personally available. 4. There is also the risk of unlimited liability, where the sole trader can be forced to sell personal assets to cover any business debts.